Hello photography fans and welcome back to another LensVid review. Today we're taking a look at the GM55 5.5 inch monitor by Godox. Let's see what this can do. Today we're taking a look at the GM55 5.5 inch field monitor made by Godox. This is an affordable option that offers lots of assist tools and includes some interesting innovations. Godox has already become a solid name in the photography market, offering quality, affordable continuous and strobe lighting solutions and accessories. Recently, the company has been branching out to include wireless audio systems and now monitors. The GM55 is the first monitor this brand offers, and based on the high quality of the rest of their innovative products, we know they can make a great device, but they'll have to innovate in order to stand out among the competition. This is a touchscreen monitor that comes with a 4K HDMI output, accurate colors, 160-degree viewing angle, custom LUT support, and multiple powering options and assist features. The GM55 is also one of the few field monitors in this price range that comes with a camera control feature. Godox ships this monitor with a sturdy plastic clip-on sunshade, tilt support, cables, and a cleaning cloth. The camera control cables are sold separately. The GM55 screen is a 400 ppi IPS touchscreen with a 16:9 ratio and a 1920x1080 resolution. Godox calls this a 4K monitor, which can be misleading since the screen isn't actually 4K, but rather the HDMI output coming out of the monitor is 4K. The monitor body is a hard plastic enclosure weighing just over 300 grams with the hood on. While it doesn't feel very solid in the hand, it's very well put together with springy buttons and a nice matte finish. The lightweight is a plus when you consider that this is an on-camera monitor. The body of the monitor features quarter-inch mounting holes on three of its sides. A big thanks to Godox for adding anti-twist locating holes to all of these mounts. These really ought to be standard on all devices by now. You know what else is great about this monitor? It reminds me of the subscribe button. Hit subscribe and hit the bell notification. The top of the monitor features six programmable function buttons on the left and a clickable menu jog wheel and a return button on the right. The left side doesn't come with a mounting hole, but has full HDMI in and out ports and a 3.5mm jack for monitoring audio. The power button is on the right side of the unit. The bottom of the fixture comes with a DC in and out port, an SD card slot for LUTs, and a camera control port. For power, the unit uses a single L-type battery that connects on the back. The connection features a plastic lock. This mechanism is pretty secure even with a bigger battery. It is made of plastic, so we wonder how it'll hold up after some use. On the back of the unit, there is also another plastic release mechanism for the camera control cable. The sunshade that's included with the monitor is refreshingly sturdy. It's a snap-on design that fits snugly, unlike some of the other Velcro-style designs that we've worked with in the past. It features a spring-loaded foldable structure that is easy to deploy and feels like it'll stand up to constant back and forth. This is a very much needed accessory for this Godox monitor, since the screen is not very bright, only 410 nits, and it'll be very hard to see anything on the screen in direct sunlight without a hood. The unit draws power from NPF batteries, but it also features a DC connection that allows you to run the device indefinitely by connecting it to a power outlet. Another useful feature on the monitor is the DC out, which you can use to power the camera with a dummy battery. A very welcome addition. There are no USB connections on this monitor. To turn the device on, press the power button on the right side of the unit. It takes around 10 seconds to power up. The programmable function buttons on the top of the monitor are marked with tiny icons. There are no markings on the front panel. The buttons are pretty small but feel clicky and responsive. The HDMI out provides a way to daisy chain the monitor to another previewing screen. In the studio, we connect this GM55 to a big screen TV using the monitor assist tools for color and focus while previewing the composition on the TV. The menu is pretty intuitive on this monitor. You can access the menu by clicking the jog wheel or double tapping anywhere on the screen. Navigate through the settings using the same jog wheel or just tap on the menu items. There's an extra camera control menu hidden on the right side of the screen. To access it, swipe left from the edge of the screen. Tap anywhere on the screen to hide it. Among the more interesting features in the menu is the automatic image flip function and programmable user configuration. As for assist functions, Godox included customizable color focus assist, two-mode false color, zebras, monochrome, pixel-to-pixel, vectorscope, histogram, zoom, markers and grid lines, and waveforms. There's a whole section in the menu to set up the color space, color temperature, hue and saturation. The top buttons on the monitor are preset for camera control, but you can reprogram them to any function that you find most useful and still have the on-screen menu to control the camera. Camera control is an interesting feature, but we had trouble with using it. Not all of our cameras were compatible, and we found the connection to the camera to be unstable, and it sometimes interfered with the HDMI feed. The on-screen camera control menu is pretty useful, since it works kinda like a tally light. When the camera is recording, the red button turns from a circle to a square. It's not the most obvious thing, but it helps. Not sure if Godox can update the interface, but a more visible tally on the screen would be great. Hopefully Godox can fix these issues through firmware upgrades, because we find the remote function to be pretty useful, for example when we shoot on our overhead rig. For reference, and as a practical experiment, we'll compare this monitor to another budget monitor and also to a more premium, bright screen monitor. The most significant advantage that the Portkeys monitor has over the GM55 is brightness. You can easily see the Portkeys image even in bright sunlight, unlike the lower brightness monitors. As for the difference between the Godox and the Feel World offers more power options, like this USB-C port and this integrated dummy battery. In conclusion, and this should come as no surprise, Godox did a good job on this monitor. Even though it's plastic, it's very well made, offers all the needed assist tools and customizable colors, and is versatile because of its power and video ports. The camera control feature is a great addition, we just have to wait for Godox to figure out how to make it run smoothly. As for pricing, Godox GM55 sells for $180, a great entry price for their first monitor, and we hope that there are more options in the works.
And that is it for our look at the GM55 monitor by Godox. Go check out the full review on our website at lensvid.com. Subscribe to this channel and come back for more videos. We'll see you in the next one.